You have no idea how hard I'm sucking my belly in. Good God. Yeah, so what we don't want to do is show them, but I dressed up. Look, I put my Hooked on Their C-shirt on just for Scott. I left my slippers on there. Welcome, everybody. I am Sam with Outdoors in Maryland, and thanks for stopping by. So, all summer long, we do crabbing, and we have about 50 pounds of crab meat put up in the freezer. And so we look for new ways to use our crab meat. So my wife, when we pick them, my wife does all the picking, and she'll let us know. She'll put when we picked it or when she picked it. Oh, we're back. The battery died. That's awesome. So here's a pound of crab meat. We got a pound and a half of crab meat. Last year, she actually separated everything. She separated the lump with the crab claws and all the other stuff, back fin and all that stuff. But this year, she didn't do that much. But there's plenty of lump in here. We got a lot of recipes on the channel. We got a cream crab soup. We got the regular vegetable crab. We got some crab balls, crab cakes, crab marinara. People were like, what? Well, we take our crab meat and we make a really Italian marinara sauce and we add crab to it. And it, to me, it tastes good if you're gonna use any kind of, put like little scallops or shrimp or anything in like a spaghetti. I think that would taste great. You can add shrimp into it with it or pour it over top of it. So I looked around to see if there was any kind of recipes that sounded interesting. I really didn't see any, but there's a show at Ocean City, Maryland that I watch religiously. I watch it all the time. And I'm more of a freshwater fisherman, what Scott does down there, Scott Lennox is the host. They do more saltwater, because they're right down on the beach. He does like the white marlin every year. He just did the inshore tournament in October. So it's a fishing show. So during this COVID stuff that we're going through, they couldn't go into restaurants. You really couldn't do it. You can't really do anything. So he did some cooking recipes at home with his wife. And this is her credit, two credits. All right. First credit, Christine Lennox. That's Scott Lennox's wife. Kristen. Is that Kristen? It's Kristen, not Christine. Kristen. No, that's right.
Kristen. Yeah, it's Kristen.
It's Kristen. Kristen, and it's an old, supposedly an old recipe that a Miss Kathy Ritten made. I'm just taking it from the video that I was watching. And it looks pretty simple. Never had it before, never heard of it before. They're called CRABBY’S. So we got all the ingredients pretty much right in front of us. The first one is you got mayonnaise. You got this is supposedly the, you can do any kind of cheese to it, but they said don't do that. They said this is the cheese. This kind of what makes the CRABBY’S. All right, we got some garlic salt, some seasoned salt, and we have one stick of butter. Softened, very softened, okay? And they did a half a pound of crab meat. We go a little overboard because we got a lot of crab meat in the freezer, and we got about a pound and a half of crab meat here. Two cups is 1 pound, that's the way we measure, okay? And we got English muffins, all right? These are just plain English muffins. It's 1 6-pack, and we're going to just follow me with the recipe. Right now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna mix everything. Their methods. There's the bowl right here. All right, so we're gonna take, you have no idea how hard it is. I got a shirt on that I just gave to my wife, but it's Hooked on OC shirt. I met Scott and Dave. So I do more freshwater fishing, and in Maryland, one of the big hot things, everybody, they love that snakeheads that are down here. So I showed Scott.
How much you're doing?
I'm sorry, that's one stick of butter. I'm gonna put the whole jar in of the Old English spread. They said you can put anything on it, but they were explaining that this is kind of the, what they think makes this CRABBY’S. It's basically going to be an appetizer. So I sent him pictures of the one day we were out, man, we were catching just anywhere from 20 inch to 35, 36, 37. I mean, as they call them now, dragons, snakeheads. We were just catching them. And I sent him pictures and he was like, man, can we go do this? I'm like, hell yeah. So him and Dave come down. Dave Messick is the person that does the filming, editing of the TV show. And the show is at Ocean City, Maryland. It comes on 7 o'clock. And what I will do, they have a YouTube channel. So everything they put up on TV comes out on YouTube. And I'll put the link in. They just had a recent one. They were doing some rock fishing out by the Route 50 bridge. Anybody knows Ocean City, Maryland? A half a teaspoon of garlic salt. All right, you got a half a teaspoon of seasoned salt. You have no idea how hard I'm sucking my belly in. Good God. This shirt's kind of tight. I let my wife usually. it's not good. I'm sucking.
But black makes you look thinner.
Yeah, okay. That's a lot of black I need. All right, so you get 1.5 tablespoons of mayonnaise. We don't want to scare the white one. So now we're just gonna mix this all up. All right, we got 1.5 pounds of crab meat. We go large with the crab meat. And she said fold it in. Now, if you really just got lump crab meat, I would really be careful. You don't want to break it up.
Yep, that's about what it looks like.
Yeah, I mean, I...
Now, are you supposed to butter these?
Nope. Okay. I think she just puts them right on. That look pretty much mixed up yet?
Yeah. Some meat over here, but...
Don't forget any of the meat. Don't forget none of the meat.
It's like gold in this house.
Yeah. All we're going to do now is just put them on top of here. But I am not the perfect cook either. I'm very messy.
You're messy. That's a lot.
So what we have here, we probably could just use, we got more muffins. We can actually make more muffins. Their recipe calls for a half a pound of crab meat with all this stuff. Now we got 1 pound of crab meat. Now this is steamed crabs. It does have a little spice with it, with the J.O. seasoning that we steam our crabs with. So I don't want to add too much salt or anything. I don't want to make it too salty. You know, because the crab meat we have is definitely have that salty taste.
Yep, just don't add so much.
Well, I know which one's mine.
Yeah, about like that. That's good, because not when you put too much on.
We're going to go ahead. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to just do the rest of these. I'm going to get it set up for the freezer. Okay. And we're going to leave them in the freezer. And you know, look, this is what we've been doing all day. Here it is. Yeah, why don't you fill the rest of that up? So we have been cooking since messing with food since like 8 o'clock this morning. No, I'm sorry, since like 7 o'clock. We got a pulled pork and we got our beans on. That's for dinner. Look at that. Oh, that look good. All right, so that's the kind of cooking we've been doing. All right, so we're gonna set it up for the freezer. Sorry, my garage is a mess. I got hunting gear out. My hunting gear is out all over the place. And I'm gonna show you, I put some wax paper from their recipe because she freezes them. And she has a very, very, very nifty way of doing it.
Look.
12. Look.
You left crab meat.
That's sacrilege.
Oh my goodness.
I'm going to get a beating now.
Yes.
So these will be frozen. So if we ever want a snack or anything, we can just pull these out of the freezer. She takes the parchment paper. She puts it in. I thought this was very nifty. Mm-hmm. I measured it. I think she only goes three.
Probably could get four, you think?
We'll do three.
Okay. You fold it over, yeah.
So we'll do three. Now we'll take a Ziploc baggie and stick them in there.
Mm-hmm.
And whenever we put a snack, we'll have them. All right, so we took them out of the oven, and now what we're doing is we're cutting them into fours, okay? She's got the oven on now for broil. No, put it on high, I think you said.
You sure?
Yeah, we're gonna put on high broil.
Okay.
All right, and it should only take, so we're gonna cut these in four. Here, you can watch me do it. And I changed my shirt. We were hearing this noise, like screaming, and it was my belly saying, please let me out. Let me out. So.
One more.
All right. So now we got it on broil, and the way it was explained to us is that it might take about 3 minutes, and then you need to really, really, really keep on your toes, because if not, you will burn them. I say you're looking pretty brown. All right, let's take them out. We're gonna take these out. They look good. They look good. All right, we're gonna let it cool off a little bit, and then we're gonna try it. See?
I need to get a better bite.
But
it's hot. Very hot.
Crunchy toast.
Like a crouton. It tastes good.
Yeah, I thought it was good too.
Yeah.
I already tried it. I'm gonna try the other half.
I like to dip it in something though. I'm a dipper. Mm-hmm. You know, cheese has a lot of salt there too. So.
Yeah, that was actually, man, that would be That's a really good appetizer. Well, man, that's good. So everything in this will be in the description. I will leave it. How long we took, theirs took about 5 or 6 minutes. Ours took a little bit longer to do to really get brown on top. But as you can see, nice and brown on top. They look wonderful. We didn't take no pictures of it whatsoever. So.
Cocktail sauce.
Cocktail sauce.
Oh yeah.
So we got a pulled pork out here. So this is what my wife does. We spend all that time making ingredients, or we spend 8-9 hours cooking a pork, and then you bring it in and then she smothers it. So she's gonna smother that. Okay, well, if you like the video, please subscribe, hit that like button, leave a comment for any, for any reason, I don't care. You'll leave a comment for anything, I don't care. But let's try this again, that was pretty bad. Hey, so if you like this video, please hit the subscribe button and the like button. And I don't know, make sure you hit that notification bell so, you know, anytime I put a new video up, it will let you know. All right, so I'll talk to you later and see ya. All right, that was still terrible. If you like the video, make sure you subscribe and hit that notification bell. That way, when I put a video up, it'll notify you. Jesus. Hey!
Not much.
No. If you like the video, make sure you hit the subscribe button and hit the notification bell. So every time I put up a new video, it will let you know. Hit the thumbs up. It really helps the channel out. And we're out of here. Till next time, when we do the pulled pork recipe, that's all coming. That's a pulled pork with our Death Punch beans. Don't let it scare you off. They're delicious.